then what about downtime?
On the PRP side, so if we just did PRP and treated your back, it's usually about a week downtime for most people. After that first week, then it's, and same with whether it's the 1 week or the 2 week, depending on what we do. Basically, once you start reintroducing some form of activity, we generally recommend treating it as if you just got injured, right? After an injury, once you start feeling, okay, maybe I could get back into it, you don't just go full gung-ho, right? You kind of put your toes in the water and you test it out and you say, okay, well, let's do, you know, just 25% of my intensity and duration, and let's see how that feels. Let's get back into physical therapy and let's start, you know, working on kind of the basics and then progressing upwards for that. Most patients are back, and you being younger, this generally happens a bit quicker, but most of the patients I work with are in their 50s and 60s, and they're back to their baseline activity levels by about 4 to 6 weeks after a spine procedure. So you might be back to your baseline activity level by maybe 3 to 4 weeks as opposed to 4 to 6. Now that doesn't mean that you'll be pain-free at that point. It just means you'll be able to tolerate the activity levels that you had before the procedure. And then over X amount of months, if that's PRP, you know, usually it's over 3 months, is where that healing will continue. The same way that, you know, if you roll your ankle at 3 months, you know, you're 90% good, but it's still not fully healed. But then over another 3 months, you get the rest of that healing. Same thing that's happening here, because we're actually going through a healing response.